What's going on YouTube? If you clicked on this video, you're probably wondering the easiest way to complete the 4th raid and unlock this projectile camo. Let me tell you, you came to the right place. If you guys could do me just one favor, if this video did help you, please leave a like on the video. And also hit that sub button so you guys don't miss out on any other Call of Duty videos. And as always, make sure you guys look out for one another, and I'll catch you in the next one. Alright, before we actually get into the raid, I want to go over the loadout that I recommend that you use to make things a little easier. Alright, for the primary, honestly, just use whatever you're most comfortable with. It really doesn't matter what one you use. The main thing is the secondary, the tactical, and the lethal. And then these are the attachments I recommend you use on the snake shot. I won't go over the tuning because the tuning doesn't really matter. Now for the tactical and lethal, as you can see, I have stims on for my tactical. And after doing the raid, I recommend you have flashes on. And you'll see in this video, there's one part where there's a lot of jugs and the flashes help a lot to get around them. Then for the lethal, I have thermites on because you can throw them again at the jugs and they help a lot.
Shit, boss the jugs!
Oh, that's actually...
Yeah, boy.
So just trust me, it'll make the raid go way more smoothly. Now that we got the loadout down, let's go hop into the actual raid. Alright, now that we're into the first part of the raid, you're gonna have one of two roles. You're either gonna be one of the two people running the cameras, or you're gonna be the person that's blindfolded. Now there's two ways of doing this. One is actually really easy, and I'll explain that one first. If you can use Discord, share your screen if you're the two people using the cameras to the person who's blindfolded. Then you can just look at his other screen, walk through the obstacles, and get through this part easily. And now comes option two. Option two isn't the easiest, but if you can't use Discord, you're just gonna have to guide the person who's blindfolded through the obstacles, and then you complete it that way. So for the first part, you're gonna let the person know once the laser moves away from them and they can make it to the box safely. And then once they make it to the box safely, they just have to go through the door, and that comes part two. And then once they go through the door, you're then gonna have to guide them to go up two sets of stairs. Then that's where the person with the second camera comes in, because they're gonna have to guide them over a jump. Then they're gonna have to go up a last set of stairs. And then the two players can get off the cameras, and your next objective is you're gonna have to distract the guard to let the person come through. All you're gonna wanna do is just keep talking with them, keep the conversation going. Then the person that's not distracting the guard is gonna be able to take off the bindings of the person who's blindfolded, and then that person can move around freely and release the two people. But before you do that, obviously take out the guard, and then you're gonna wanna go over and hit the red button, and that will release the two people that were in the cells. Then once you're freed from the jail cells, you're gonna wanna pick up one of the weapons and then go left down the staircase and make sure you shoot all the enemies through these windows. It makes it a lot easier. Then once everyone is eliminated, you're gonna wanna jump out the window. Watch out for the laser, and you're all going to meet up at this door. And then through this door, this is where you're going to get your ammo, your plates, and more importantly, your loadout. And just for a little trick, if you do want to hold more plates in your inventory, once you plate up, if you drop your initial three and then go hit the plate box, it'll fill up your whole inventory, then just go back to the ground and pick them up. And then you're going to want to go through this door, drop down, and there is two ways of doing this next part. I'll explain the way that we did not do. If you go under the vehicles and just crawl all the way through, you can do it the more silent way, but we decided to just go through and just eliminate everybody. But the way that we did it, you're going to want to make sure you stay on top of the vehicles when you're going forward. There's a bunch of booby traps and claymores and bouncing betties and everything, so just climbing over the vehicles makes it a lot easier. Then once you get to the end, you're going to want to go into this door and go up the stairwell. You're going to want to go hold this red button to let your teammate get through the gate. Then once they get through the gate, they can hold the button on that side to let you through. After you get through that door, you're going to go down these stairs into this room. We're going to run to this cable and you're all going to melee it, and the thing is going to drop down and reveal a hole. It is safe to fall down in this hole, because once you get down there, this is where the laser puzzle starts. You're going to start from jumping from the top of these missiles over to these orange barrels, and then you're going to use these pile of crates. You're going to jump on the first one and then jump on top of the second one. Then what you're going to want to do is wait for the lasers to create a gap to where you and one teammate can land. You are then going to crouch under this laser and then just jump to the door. All three of your teammates do have to regroup to the door, so this is a very hard part, because if one person messes up, you gotta redo it. And then once you all make it to the door, you can walk in and disable the trap. Congratulations, you beat the laser puzzles. Sadly, I am just kidding, you have two more laser puzzles to do, but don't worry, I'll walk you through it, make it as easy as possible. All right, for the second laser puzzle, what you're gonna wanna do is walk up, and once they create a direct path right to this middle part where the crates and this pole is, you're gonna run there, crouch or prone, just so you don't get hit by the other lasers. And then what you're gonna wanna wait for is a set of three lasers that you see right here that are coming towards us. Once that passes you, it creates a direct path where you can run through, then go to the left to where you're gonna wait for your teammates. And once all three of your teammates have made it to this door, just gonna walk through and again disable the trap, and then you're on to the third and final laser puzzle. So for this third and final puzzle, to make it as easy as possible, what you're gonna want to do is wait for the lasers to start moving counterclockwise, then you're gonna jump down and jump on this first pole. Then from the first pole, you're gonna jump to the second pole, and then from the second pole, you're gonna jump to the tops of these boxes. Then once you see the lasers pass the third pole, you're gonna jump from the boxes to the third pole, then from there to the end. Then again, once your three teammates have successfully done this, You just regroup at the door. And this is where you can refill on ammo and plates again. Then through the door, you're gonna again disable all the lasers. Then you're just gonna have to eliminate a bunch of enemies through here. Now there are trophy systems, so you can't use any of the thermites or flashes or any lethal or tacticals. Then once you eliminate all the enemies, you're just gonna go to this space and crawl through it. Drop down into this room. And you are now into the juggernaut zone.
Mighty, I'm scared.
Then once you get into this room, just like at the beginning, each person is going to have a certain task. One person is going to be staring at this mini-map that you see here. The blue marks are you and your teammates, and each red dot is an enemy juggernaut. But the objective here is to kill only one certain juggernaut that's going to drop a key card. That juggernaut is marked by a skull, as you can see on the map. So the one person that's going to stay back and look at the map has to guide you through the paths to get to that juggernaut and kill them to grab that key card. Then once you grab that key card, you're going to take it to a specific room that's already marked on the map. Then once you get into that room, you're going to pick up a nuclear element. And I forgot to mention that there is going to be fire that's going to sometimes block your path. All you have to do is have the person that's in the map room go turn the wheel that's going to turn the fire off. So once you grab the nuclear element, the objective is to get it back to the map room where you started. Once you do pick up the element, there is one catch. The person that's holding it will take damage and your screen will slowly turn black. So you're either going to have to drop it or rotate it between the two players to get it back to the map room. Then once you make it back to the map room, you're going to go through this door. You're going to deposit the warhead into this case. So then you're going to go up the stairs and you're going to backtrack a little bit. Go down the tunnel and regroup at this door. Then at the door, you're going to turn right and go through the place where you already cleared all the enemies. Then regroup at this gate, and you're going to use that key card that you got from that juggernaut to get through this door. Then you have made it to the final part of this raid. For this final part, you have to meet Hadir at the top of the elevator because he's trying to escape. What you're going to want to do is go to the left and take the zipline all the way up. Once you get to the top of the zipline, you are timed, so you want to make sure you try to do this as fast as possible. The next objective is to clear each floor, so you're just going to have to run through and eliminate each enemy. This is where the snake shot comes in handy. Then each floor, once you eliminate enemies, you're going to have to go up the stairs to go to the next floor. Some floors will have this red button. What you're going to want to do is hold it to where you let your teammates through, and then there's a red button on the other side to let you through the gate. And then once you get to the top, you're gonna have to jump over and wait for the elevator to get to a height to where you can jump and not die to fall damage. Then once you get on top of the elevator, you and your teammates are gonna have to knock each cable on each side, so just go up to it and melee it. And once you knock the elevator down, you just got to make sure you get to the bottom. And once you get to the bottom, you're going to refill your ammo. Make sure you have a bunch of plates because you're going to regroup at this door and it's going to start a bunch of waves of killing enemies. First couple waves are going to be normal soldiers and ones with armor. And then the last wave is going to be the one with juggernauts. That's where those thermites and the flash grenades are going to help a ton. And then once you eliminated all the jugs, you have successfully finished the fourth raid. All you're going to want to do is go back to that elevator door and then you'll get the final cutscene. After the cutscene, you'll get the pop-up saying you unlocked the projectile camo. If this video did help you guys out, please make sure to leave a like on the video. Also, comment down below. I'm curious to see your guys' opinion on this camo. As always, hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys in the next one.